So today we are going to see how we can make our button in Android Studio. We can have a round corner or different shape, circle or whatever you like in different colors. So there is a formation or a format which you can provide in your Android Studio. For this you have to make a new empty project and you have to create some XML file. This XML file I will be providing you. So make a new Android empty project. Then this XML, the file can be linked to your Android background while you are making a text box. So we'll make a project and just we'll give two buttons. This is our button. And what we will do is on the background of the button, we'll just set this XML file. So we'll start this Android Studio. And once we start the Android Studio, then I'll show you that how and where to put this XML file. Say next, because this is a very basic project. You just have to make two press next. You just have to make button, simple button, and we'll change the look and feel of the button. This is required because Android does not provide the way, because there are various properties. And if you want to change the properties, it will not allow you. So this is resource folder. In this, we have a drawable folder, if you can see. Drawable folder. And inside this, we have to do the stuff. But before that, I'll go to activity main .xml. I'll go to the design. And once I am on the design, what we'll do is, we'll try to make buttons here. So drag button. This is our first button, and you can reshape it at your will. Then we can have another button. So we'll drag one more button here, and this button, first button, will change first. And then just by changing the colors, by changing the size, we'll try to show you that how look and feel can be changed. You can have various buttons. So just let me run this application for you on my emulator so that you can see that how it is looking right now and how it is going to change in later session. By the time that app is running, let me show you that the folder or the stuff I am going to provide you, it will contain my button.xml. This is first XML, and this XML is quite easy. You know that you have a selector. In this selector we have item. And in this item, we have shape. Inside shape, we have three properties. So this shape is rectangle. I have given rectangle. These are three items. This is rectangle, which we are providing. And you can change the shape at your will. Means you can make it circle or depending upon your requirement. So I am making it rectangle. This is the stroke. And this is a gradient. Now, you want to have a color. And then you want to have a gradient also. Means once you press the button, then you want to have a you know, ripple like smooth ripple like pressing output. For that you need to have this stroke gradient, but this is not mandatory. You can release or you can just delete this gradient if you don't want, but this is just for sake of completion. And now this is the XML file. You need to copy it. I showed you the content, and I need to copy it. And in the resource drawable folder, you'll have a drawable folder inside this resource of your app. I will just right click it, and I'll try to copy this. And if you want, you can make a new XML file also. You can just go to new and make a file, but here I'm just trying to copy it. So I'm pasting it. This is my mybutton.xml file which I just showed you. And this mybutton.xml has come, and if you can see, it is shown in the editor also. This is a simplest file, and you can just remove all this. You can have just one selection, one item, that will also suffice. But I want that once I press, once I you know, move my cursor on this, I want to have a different look and feel, and you'll see it in the result also in short while from now. This is the color. You can go to HTML picker and have different color. Right now, you see that I'm just pressing it, and you see a ripple like effect means a realistic effect, because if you are going to Android, you need something new, just not like what we make in Visual Basic or other stuff. We don't want a static type of thing. We want something to be very, very appealing to the user. So this is the line you have to add. Please concentrate on this line. This is the line: Android background is equal to drawable. And why drawable? Because it is inside your drawable. And you just have to link this my button. See, I am just pasting it somewhere. You can place it anywhere inside this button. So I am placing it. Now I have a background drawable. And let me run it for you. And let me show you the changes which the button will have. So this app is running. And the first button we have changed. See, the button has changed. The button has changed. The color was dark green, and once you press it, once you change your mouse or move or hover your mouse, now I want to make a different button also. So this is my second XML file, but the first and second is entirely identical. The only change is, let me copy it first for you, then I'll show you. Copy again, go to your drawable folder, paste it. And no capital letters in the XML file, because Android will not accept it. This is my large button. Only I have changed the size, the width and the size and the color. Only this width, size and color has been changed. So this you have to put in your second button. If you want to have two buttons with different look and feel, you have to have a two XML files. Now I am pasting it anywhere you can paste Android background, and now let me run it for you. And the first one was typical green, and the other is I'm going to give you in some bluish color. See, the second one has come, and this is the, and when I press it, it changes to orange color. See, this is an orange color. So this is how you work with buttons, and you give a round corner to the button. Quite easy to understand. Thank you so much.